Da ønsker vi velkommen til et nytt program på Israelkanalen, og nå er vi faktisk i Israel, det lovede land, og vi er ikke bare i Israel, men vi er i kjernelandet i Israel. Og her har jeg med meg Jan Willem van der Hoven, og han er det veldig mange som kjenner, for han har vært en stor predikant i 40 år, og han har vært i Norge mange, mange ganger. Han har en stor gruppe med tilhengere i Norge som har nytt godt av hans forkynnelse, som alltid er aktuell og alltid er rett inn i Bibelens kjernebudskap. Welcome, Jan Willem.
God bless you, Anne-Marie, and I'm thankful that you're still there with all your love for the Lord and Israel, and may God keep you many years still.
Thank you very much. Han er takknemlig for å få lov å være med på programmet. What is your main message for the Norwegian people?
I have a deep love for Norway, and of course also Ellen, my wife, who is half Scandinavian and speaks fluent Norwegian. And we are coming to Norway in the end of March. And I have a burning message upon me that Norway will not become part of the European Union. And I believe it's from God that they are not yet. Because if they would join under the pressure of the leftists and liberals, who said we must be part of the European Union, they will lose all their money to the bankruptcy of the European nations, especially Greece and Portugal and others, and never see it again. Norway is blessed with oil, and because of the oil, she is prosperous, maybe the most prosperous country in Europe. And my prayer is that the Christians will so awake now that they have a new government that can choose, if there is enough pressure by the prayers of the Christians to God upon that government of Siv Jensen and others, that they will choose a strategic alliance with Israel rather than to be one with the European Union. And I feel, I have always felt, I said, Lord, let Norway be a sheep nation. It's like a shofar. Physically in its geography, you know, from Hammerfest down to Kristiansand in Oslo. I said, let it be a shofar, an example. When all the Europeans who are now on their way to boycott Israel, and that's how the Holocaust started. Kauft nicht bei dem Juden. Do not buy with the Jews. And they don't understand that Israel is again threatened by a new Hitler called Khatami, the Iranian leadership, who openly says, I want to finish what Hitler has left. And what does Europe do? They go the same way as on the eve of the Holocaust. Kauft nicht bei dem Juden, as in Germany at least it was.
Det er et utrolig engasjement han viser, og en utrolig faktisk kjærlighet for Norge. Han er veldig opptatt av mange ting, men blant annet så snakker han om den nye regjeringens mulighet til å snu trenden i Norge, den trenden som da har gått ut på å kritisere Israel hele tiden. Og han sier at han håper at den nye regjeringen vil ikke reflektere på å bli med i EU, for han sier at da kommer alle pengene våre til å forsvinne i store gap i Portugal og Italia og Spania, og vi vil aldri se dem igjen. Så han håper at Siv Jensen og resten av regjeringen vil støtte opp om Israel og ikke følge trenden til Europa, som faktisk er det samme som førte frem til Holocaust, sier han. Fordi Holocaust begynte også med at jødene hadde skylden for alle ting, og det er det vi ser også i Europa. Folk boykotter Israel, de boykotter for de rareste ting. Og det er, jeg synes det er veldig rørende å høre på hans engasjement. It's very very moving to hear about your engagement for Europe and for Norway. You could rest down here in this beautiful place and be blessed.
Yes, but I am a European and I'm also a servant of the Lord. And don't forget that we are here in Anathoth, where Jeremiah the prophet lived and he spoke. He was the prophet to the nations. And I feel the Lord has given me a prophetic message to the nations. And that's what I do now here with you. I feel that God has given me a message, not just for Christians in Norway, but for Norway. And I've met Siv Jensen twice, and I'm so thankful that she's now Minister of Finance in this government.
Han sier at han er en europeer, og han har fått et kall av Gud til å være en profet. Og han bor faktisk helt på stupet av Juda-ørkenen, Judea-ørkenen. Og der var profeten Jeremias, og han føler at han kanskje går i hans fotspor, og hans oppgave er å advare. Og han har møtt Siv Jensen, og han tror på henne, og han tror på mulighetene til å forandre Norge.
And I'm working with a South African wonderful journalist, and he took it up for the black people in the time that they were discriminated against in South Africa. So he has a clean past in that relationship with the discrimination. And he says, I know what discrimination did to the black. And to say the Israelis are discriminating against Palestinians. And he wrote the whole article. He says, if the Israelis would discriminate, as the European and the Western world often want to say, then they should do this. And then he lists all that the white government did to the black. None of the things the Israelis do. The Israelis allow the Palestinians, even after all they have done in suicide attacks, to be on their beaches, to see in their restaurants. There's not for whites only in restaurants or in buses. So he says, I fought for the blacks, he said, but I fight now to see the hypocrisy of the nations towards Israel, who has opened their hearts and have 11 members of parliament that they pay, who continually criticize Israel and are closer to the Palestinians than they are to the Israelis that they are supposed to serve.
Han snakket med en sørafrikansk berømthet, journalist, og han forteller om apartheid og hvordan disse svarte ble diskriminert. Men han sier at Israel, de diskriminerer ingen, og du kan dra hvor som helst i Israel og du vil finne palestinere, og du vil finne alle folkeslag. De er hjertelig velkommen. De er på bussene, og de er på strendene, og de er overalt. Og han sier at det er ikke tegn til apartheid i Israel, men det fremstilles jo slik i Norge.
Even after all the terrorist attacks, they have more freedom than the blacks had in South Africa.
Til og med etter alle disse terrorangrepene som Israel er utsatt for hele tiden, så har de mer frihet enn de sorte hadde i Afrika. You are busy with politics in Israel also. What do you think about the situation? You have always, not always, but again and again, visitor from America.
I was so blessed to receive 4 days ago personal phone call from the Prime Minister. We see him often, but it was so nice that with all the business and the pressure of John Kerry, the Secretary of State, upon him and the Europeans, that he took time just before he entered in the Shabbat to phone me. And he phoned me, and I'm so happy to say this on this program. He says, will you thank the Norwegian pastors for this wonderful declaration that they've made? And you know, we gave it to him, the statement of these 22 leaders, Christian leaders in Norway, who God had spoken to ask Israel for forgiveness for the Oslo Accords, and for the prime minister to phone me when the whole world is pressurizing him to do what they promised to Arafat in Oslo, and thank these pastors. I said, Lord, and for 2 months it did not rain. And then I felt to give him a word. I says, I have a word for you. God said to Moses, to Joshua, as I was with Moses, I will be with you. Only be strong and very courageous. And he said to me, that's Joshua. And then I felt God is going to give him the strength. I know many Norwegians pray for him. And it began to rain. Just half a day after I had this conversation, I felt, Lord, you don't want this nation that you've given to Israel to be divided. And as long as the Israeli leaders will stay with you, you will bless them even with rain.
Det var 22 norske pastorer her nede og for en stund siden, og de sendte en dedikasjon til Netanyahu, hvor de ba han om å stå fast, og de sa at de var med ham, at de ba for ham. Og han ble veldig rørt for det, og ba Jan Willem om å sende en takk tilbake og si at det rørte dem. Den dedikasjonen ble oversatt til hebraisk og lest opp i knesset, og det er jo da herved overbrakt den hilsenen til disse pastorene. Og Jan Willem sa at jeg har et ord til deg, og det er det samme ordet som Gud ga til Josva. Han sa det at jeg var med Moses, og nå skal jeg være med deg. Og så sa Jan Willem til Netanyahu at det ordet gir jeg til deg.
Og be very courageous. I said, the Lord said to Joshua, be of great courage. And that's what all the Israeli ministers need today. Courage to withstand the pressures of Europe and America.
Gud sa også det til Joshua, at han skulle ha mot og være dristig. Og det er det også de israelske lederne må være. De må ha mot og være dristige. Og da vil Gud være med dem. Jan Willem tror ikke på en delt stat, og det er godt å høre at han er fast på det. You don't see an alternative to this divided state.
What touched me is that Eric Seller, who is bringing me now to speak all over Norway, he said to me, Jan Willem, there's something has happened to Norway. And I felt, because they came and brought this confession and statement of support to all the Knesset members, and I took it for them to the Prime Minister. And Eric Seller said to me, he was in a meeting in Norway, I think in Alesund, and he said, Johan, something has happened. Something has happened. We've turned. And I said, Lord, when we say sorry, there is a new relationship. If you say sorry to a person you've hurt, there's a new relationship. There's a new relationship if we have sinned against God or his people and we say sorry, there's a new relationship. And I thought, God, it's going to happen. The devil always wants what the Lord wants. Jesus said to Peter, the devil has wanted you because he knew you're going to be one of my best apostles. And he wanted Oslo and Norway to go the wrong way. He says, I know what God is going to do through Norway. And he attacks the channel that God is going to use. So now that they said, forgive us for Oslo, forgive us for Oslo. Eric Seller said, Jan Willem, something has happened. We have a new government, but there is a new atmosphere. And so I feel I'm coming right in the right time to Vision Norge, to the churches. And if the Christians now will let this slip, then it's their business and responsibility.
Ja, det var både en oppmuntring og en advarsel. Han refererer til møter som er holdt hvor folk har bedt om unnskyldning for Oslo-avtalen i Norge. Og han sier at hvis du ber noen om unnskyldning, så kommer du i et annet forhold. Altså det blir et nytt forhold når du sier unnskyld til folk. Og han synes det er et fantastisk lyspunkt at kristne mennesker i Norge nå har begynt å si unnskyld. Og han mener at det er en oppvåkning blant kristne til å støtte opp om Israel, og da sier jeg også Guy de Warsawel. Så han kommer til Norge slutten av mars, og synes han kommer da i den rette tiden.
Amen.
Og det, vi ønsker ham hjertelig velkommen til det.
Very good. Lord, we just pray together for Norway. I believe this is such an example what has happened, and I know that people have written me from Australia, from South Africa, from Holland. Why don't we do in Holland and in South Africa what the pastors in Norway have done? We should ask also for forgiveness. Lord, Norway is going to be a trumpet of you to other nations to follow their example. Will you bless these pastors? Will you make them strong? And will you cut out of the hearts of the liberal pastors who are more concerned about what the political rightness of the atmosphere is than what your word says. Make them again faithful to your word, that he who blesses Israel, you will bless, and that the nation that does not bless Israel, you will curse. May Norway not be cursed, but blessed from now on.
Amen. Han brukte et morsomt bilde i sted. Han kalte Norge for en sjofar. Norge kan bli en sjofar. Kartet ser ut sånn fra Hammerfest og ned til Kristiansand. Og han sa at Norges eksempel er nå blitt lagt merke til utover hele verden. Og han har fått mange meldinger fra Australia og rundt omkring. Hvor de, Holland, ikke minst Holland, hvor de har sagt at vi også ønsker å følge Norges eksempel, altså de 22 pastorene, og be om unnskyldning. Så kanskje det kommer en ny tid også for Europa og for Norge. Da har jeg bare lyst til å si, Jan Wilhelm er europeer. Han er ikke jøde, og han bor her i midt i Jerusalem. Han bor faktisk på Vestbredden. How did you get permanent residence here? It's not so easy.
No, but I'm very thankful that the Israeli government or authority gave me. It is not easy, but my father was private secretary to the Queen of Holland, and when there was a problem, because they rather give you 1 year or 2 years. And I felt that the Lord wanted me to be permanently here. And my son and daughter have gone into the Israeli army, which, of course, the Israelis and the prime minister is so happy that we did. And so my father went to the Israeli ambassador in The Hague. He says, my son has done so much for you in Holland, because I spoke over Holland, and it was very nice for my mother. I spoke to thousands of people and was interviewed on television, and nearly all the papers interviewed me and said, Mr. van der Hoeven, more pro-Israel than Moshe Dayan. It was 20 years ago. And then two ladies who had suffered the Holocaust in a little attic in Holland, they phoned my mother and said, I mean, it's because of God's grace on me. They said, Mrs. van der Hoeven, we Jews feel safe when your son is in the country. And they came to the Congress Hall in The Hague, the Jews and the Christians, and they gave me standing ovation, because they suddenly had a man who spoke in defense for them. And most of the Christians, even the Christians, they are so lukewarm, or they criticize Israel. When the Bible says, and I say that now, in the name of God, comfort ye. God speaks, not to, just a pastor. God says to us, comfort you. Comfort you, my people. They have suffered double. And you see now, 6 million died, with all the children, all the humiliation, and all the suffering. I've read so many books about the Holocaust. And you would think, well, The wheelchair says, this shall never happen again. And what do we see? Europe is trying to boycott Israel, not Iran. I mean, Iran a little bit, but not other nations, let me put it this way. Israel is being boycotted at the very moment that the new Hitler, the Iranian regime, wants to fulfill the ideology of the Nazis and wash Israel into the Mediterranean. And what do the world do? Who have said it shall never happen again? They criticize Israel.
Da blir det det siste ordet, tror jeg, fordi han har nå fortalt hvorfor han ble tillatt å bo her nede som ikke-jøde. Og det er mange jeg har hørt i Norge som spør hvordan skal vi få det til? Det er ikke så lett som sagt, men han har da brukt hele livet sitt til å, som han sier, trøste og stå opp for å preke om Israel. Og hans far var høyt oppe i Holland som kongens sekretær, eller dronningens sekretær. Jeg vet ikke om det har hatt så mye å si, men hans to barn har tjenestegjort her nede i det militære. Han har altså vist også i gjerning at han elsker Israel, og han jobber for Israel. Og det har da gitt han denne fantastiske velsignelsen der å bo her, like på stupet av Judea-ørkenen. Og det er sikkert veldig mange tanker han gjør seg om det. Så han gjentok da dette med holocaust som truer om igjen, fordi hele Europa boykotter Israel, og i stedet så backer de opp Iran, som jo har sagt klart fra at Israel skal utslettes. Så la dette være en liten wake-up call til norske kristne først og fremst, men også andre gode norske mennesker som jeg vet står med Israel. Så får vi håpe at vi kan være et foregangsland også når det gjelder å bygge opp sympati for Israel. Thank you very much for coming here and that we could come here. And thank you for your support and your everlasting love for this country.
Anna Marie, I bless you because I've known you for many years and I know that you've done as much for the Jewish people as I've tried to do. And I just bless you that you are here still. I think it's a miracle how God has kept you alive through all the physical attacks on your body. And that's not for nothing. The devil hates people that speak up for Israel. We have a new government in Norway. And there is a new relationship because we've said sorry that all of us have to do when we have sinned. But that opens up a new relationship of love and hope also for Norway and Israel.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Da sier vi takk for i dag. Takk for at dere hørte på oss. Vi kommer tilbake igjen.